Hello everybody, this is Doug from the Gamers with Glasses back here in this is Game Maker, not Minecraft. So, in the last tutorial I showed you how to debug the code, and I wanted to show you how to make a dice with if statements. And this is the main thing this is going to be for is if you want to kind of have like a treasure chest and you want to have like 100 different items, you're going to roll a dice for 100 sides and it's going to choose whatever if statement you have, and it's going to give the player the item. So what I learned, this does not work, and this is what a lot of people have. Basically it says random, it's going to have four sides, and it's going to give it +1 in case it rolls a zero. It's still going to be one. So this is going to be outputting, and then if you have if statements, it's going to be bad. Nothing's going to happen basically. So let's show you what I mean real quick. You can see it in the last tutorial, but in case you're just watching this one. So as you can see, nothing happens when he's supposed to be moving. And this is because right here, as you can see, it's showing decimal points. It's not showing exact variables. So it's fine if you want to roll like one or two sides and you want to have it. If it's greater than three, then it'll do a thing. And that's fine. But if you want to have it list out a bunch of items and be equal to something, then you're going to have a problem. It's not going to do anything. So what we want to do is we want to change this random thing, basically, and we're just going to add a really simple thing. We're going to add floor, and that all it's saying now, instead of what it was saying before, is it's saying round down, no matter what, round down to what you got. So let's run it again, and I'll show you what I mean. And it'll actually start moving all around the screen and shit. So, let's see. And main thing you want to pay attention to is right there. So as you can see, it's outputting different... It's not putting out outputting decimals anymore. So it's just outputting one thing. So, like I said, you can use this if you want to have, like, an item... give it to an item, or if you want to make a, like, I'm using it in this game right now in my class to spawn things eventually. Basically it's gonna, if it equals one, then it's gonna spawn something. If it equals two, it's gonna spawn something else, blah 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 blah, you know. And you can also use it for chest items, inventory. You can, main thing you also want to use it for is if you're making a fighting game, you can, if it rolls on one, then it's going to do one damage. If it rolls on two, it's going to do two, three, you know, blah blah blah, or however much you want to do. So thanks for watching everybody. This has been Doug from the Gamers with Glasses. Make sure you subscribe and like this video if you in fact like this video. And if you want to see more tutorials, I can always bring you more, but remember, I'm not an expert at this. This is actually all from my teacher in the class I'm taking on this subject right now, so have to thank him. So thanks for watching everybody. Have a good day. Bye.